Hi friends, welcome back to the new session. In the previous session, we have discussed about 1 to 50 questions, 1 to 50 MCQ's questions from general science topic. In this session, we will discuss about 51 to 100 questions in physics topic. If you haven't watched my previous video, which has 1 to 50 important questions, which are taken from various competitive examination, the link is in the given description below. Please go and watch it. Let us start the session. First question. Before discussing about the answer, pause the video and try to tell the answer and verify whether your answer is correct or not. So, 51st question. Which one of the following color has maximum energy? So, here violet has maximum energy because violet wave have shortest wavelength. So wavelength of violet rays has shortest wavelength of visible light spectrum and they carry most energy. So it carry most energy. Violet rays carries most energy. If you remember the word WebZR, WebZR, WebZR. In WebZR, V is violet, I is indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Here V has means violet has maximum energy, whereas R means red has lowest energy. So maximum is violet and minimum is red. So here he is asking about maximum violet. Option A is correct answer. Next question. The Bernoulli's theorem is, let us see what is the Bernoulli's equation first. So Bernoulli's equation is P1 by rho plus V1 square by 2 plus G Z1 equal to P2 by rho plus V square by 2 plus G Z2 equal to constant. So this is the Bernoulli's equation, which is derived from Euler's equation. So here P1 by rho is indicates the flow work. It will indicate the flow work. Here V1 by 2, V1 square by 2 is kinetic energy and GZ1 is potential energy. So this is derived from conservation of energy. Here the Bernoulli's theorem is energy conservation. Option A is correct answer. Next question. Who developed the atom bomb? Atom bomb was developed by J. Robert. So here option B is correct answer. Edward Tyler, Samuel Cron and Werner von Braun is wrong. So J. Robert is the correct answer. Next question. Relative humidity is expressed in. Let us see what is meant by humidity first. So here the humidity means the amount of water in the air. The amount of the water in the air is known as humidity. It is the relative humidity will express it in percentage. So option C is correct answer. Next question. What is the SI unit of temperature? We all know the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. So here option A is correct answer. Next question. Which of the following has highest resistivity? Let us see what is meant by resistivity. Resistivity is a measure of a resistant power of a specific material to flow of an electric current. So the metal which can allow or which can resist the amount of electric current through pass through it. So here the highest resistivity element is germanium. So option D is correct answer. If he is asking about lowest one, here the lowest one is silver. Silver has lowest resistivity. So highest is germanium and lowest is silver. Next question. X-rays was invented by. X-rays was invented by Hopkins. Wrong answer. Rontgen is right answer. Option B is correct answer. Morris wrong. Marconi is also wrong answer. So here Rontem is the correct answer. Option B is correct. Next, therm is the unit of. Let us see what is meant by a therm. Therm is here, the therm is non-SI unit. It is non-SI unit. So non-SI unit of heat energy. So option B is correct answer. Next question, the average weight of human brain about. The average weight of human brain is 1.46 kgs, which is approximately 2% of total body weight. So here the average weight of human body is 1.46. Option C is correct answer. Next question, who developed the hydrogen bomb? So hydrogen bomb is developed by Edward Teller. Edward Teller, option C is correct answer. He developed the hydrogen bomb. So next, solar radiation. Solar radiation is measured by, actually solar radiation is measured by pyrometer. Here the astrometer is a measure of electric current. Electric current is measured by astrometer, and barometer is a measure of air pressure. Air pressure, or we can say atmospheric pressure, is measured by barometer. So manometer will also measure the pressure difference. So pressure difference is measured by manometer. Here he is asking about solar radiation is measured by pyrometer. Option A is correct. Next, instrument used to measure potential difference. Potential difference between two points. So ammeter is used to measure the current. So voltmeter is also wrong. Pyrometer is also wrong. Sorry, voltmeter is the correct answer. Here flux meter is used to measure the magnetic flux. So here it is wrong. So pyrometer is used to solar radiation. Solar radiation. So ammeter is used to measure the electric current. So we'll use it to measure the electric current. Voltmeter is the correct answer. Voltmeter is used to measure the potential difference between two points. Next question, which of the following has lowest resistivity? So as I said earlier, germanium will have highest and silver has lowest resistivity. Next question, who was the inventor of scooter? Scooter was invented by Wim Opter. Option D is correct answer. Bradshaw is wrong. Adam Larry is wrong. And Einstein is also wrong. Option D is correct answer. Next one, what is the SI unit of power of lens? The SI unit of power of lens is, what is the unit of SI unit of power? As we know, Edge is a wrong answer and Faraday is wrong. Option C is correct answer. Diopter. Diopter is the correct answer. Option C. So coming to the next question, which of the following part of sun rays makes the solar cooker hot? Solar cooker, which part of the solar sun rays makes the solar cooker hot, is infrared rays. So option A is correct answer. Next one, least distance of vision, distinct vision of human eye. So least one is 25 centimeter. Option B is correct answer. Next, which type of the force acts on a body moving in a circular path? So here the answer is centripetal force. Option B is correct answer. Let us see what is the centripetal force with this diagram. So it is a circular path. If a person is moving in a circular path, the centripetal force will act towards the person. So here this is momentum. So from this we can say centripetal force is a force that acts on a human body moving in a circular path, and is the direction towards the center around which the body is moving. it will act towards the center. So this force is centripetal force. Next question, which of the following is optical illusion? Mirage is a optical illusion. So option B is correct answer. Loudness of noise is measured in decibels. Option B is correct. In radio transmission, what does FM? FM stands for frequent modulation, frequency moderation, frequency modulation, frequency monitoring. So option C, frequency modulation, is the correct answer. Tidal waves on sea is mainly due to let us see what will happen, why these tidal waves are coming in the sea. Let us take gravity of moon on earth. So what the gravity effect of moon on the earth. So what is the gravity effect? Is moon is closest heaviest body to the earth. So moon is the closest body to the earth. The sun approximately 400 times farther than the moon. Hence the gravitation pull is weaker than the moon. So the tidal waves are mainly caused by gravitational interaction between this moon and the earth. So tidal waves on the sea is mainly due to the gravitational effect of moon on the earth. Why? Because moon is very nearer to the earth, whereas sun is far away from the earth. So option C is correct answer. Next one, hertz is a unit of frequency. So option A is correct answer. Next, when a body is called supersonic, let us see what is supersonic and what is this. Before that, we need to know what is Mach number. Mach number is the speed of, let us consider an aircraft. So if we consider the aircraft, so speed of the aircraft to the speed of sound. So this is known as Mach number. Mach number is defined as the ratio of speed of some object by speed of the sound. We will compare like this. If Mach number, we can say Mach number is less than 1, then it is called as subsonic. If Mach number is greater than 1, it is supersonic. If Mach number is greater than 5, it is hypersonic. So here he is asking about supersonic. Supersonic is Mach number where greater than 1. So here option 1 is correct. This one is hypersonic. This one is subsonic. Okay. Next question. Gamma rays was discovered by Paul Villard. Paul Villard is the correct answer. Rutherford wrong. Henry is wrong. Rontgen is also wrong. So Paul Villard is the correct answer. Next question. Lightest element in periodic table. So lightest element in the periodic table is, generally the lightest element is hydrogen. Hydrogen is the lightest element. So after that helium, after that lithium. If in the option hydrogen is there, so it is hydrogen. So here of in the given option lithium is given, so option B is correct answer. The unit of noise pollution, is decibel. Option A is correct answer. Next one, SI unit of electric charge. Electric charge SI unit is coulomb. Option B is correct. Hardest element of periodic table is diamond. Platinum is not. So diamond is the hardest element of the table, and we can say we have a lot of many elements which are hardest. Among them, we can say purest element of carbon. if the carbon has purest, then it would be a hardest element. So even we have ceramics, all those stuff. So here hardest element in the periodic table is carbon. Next, the phenomena of electromagnetism was first explained by, it was first explained by Oersted. So option C is correct answer. Maxwell wrong, Faraday's wrong, Simon is also a wrong answer. Ohm. Next one. Question number 81. Lumen is the unit of luminous flux. Next one, question number 82. One joule equal to 0.24 calories. So we can remember is 1 joule is equal to 0.24 calories. Option B is correct answer. Next question, which of the following is a scalar unity? Scalar unit or scalar is which has magnitude only. Scalar quantity is a quantity which has only magnitude. Vector is which has both magnitude as well as direction. So which has direction and magnitude, it is called as vector. So velocity will have magnitude and direction. So this one is wrong. Force also will have, displacement is also will have, work only have magnitude. So option C is correct answer. In sonar, which kind of wave is used? In the sonar, the ultrasonic waves are used. Let us see what is the full form of sonar. The full form of sonar is sound navigation and ranging. Next one, what is the escape velocity of earth? The escape velocity of the earth is 11.2 kilometer per second. Option 2 is B is correct answer. Next one, what is the escape velocity of moon? The escape velocity of the moon is 2.4 kilometer per second. So option A is correct answer. Next question, barometer. Barometer is used to measure, as I said, like barometer is used to measure air pressure, or we can tell atmospheric is correct answer. Option A is correct answer. Barometer is used to measure either is we can say air pressure or atmospheric pressure. So here the low pressure will measured by vacuum gauge. Vacuum gauge is used to measure the lower pressure. Broadened tube pressure gauge will use it to high pressure, and pressure difference is wrong. So barometer is used to measure the atmospheric pressure. This is an important bit. So next question, parsec is a unit of astronomical distance. So let us see what is one astronomical distance. So let us see, this one is sun. In the middle we have sun. So here it is earth. We can say from the earth to sun, so the average distance between earth and sun is known as one astro unit. So we can say astro unit, one astro unit is the average distance between sun and the earth. So one astronomical unit. So one astronomical unit is 150 million kilometers. So it is 150 million kilometers. So here parsec is a unit of astronomical distance. Next question, which is the most suitable unit of expressing nuclear radius? So nuclear radius is Fermi is the right answer. Fermi is the most suitable unit for expressing nuclear radius. Next one, who developed the missile? The missile was developed by Wernher von Braun. Option A is correct answer. Next question, which one of the following has minimum wavelength? So gamma rays will have the minimum wavelength. So gamma rays will have minimum, and the radio waves will have maximum wavelength. So we can say in the electromagnetic spectrum includes longest wavelength to shortest wavelength as radio waves. First one is radio wave, next one is microwave, next one is infrared, next one is optical, next UV, ultraviolet, X-rays and gamma rays. So this is the order of electromagnetic spectrum from longest to shortest. So here he is asking minimum, so gamma rays. If he is asking about maximum, it is radio waves. Next question, device used to measure the speed of wind. The speed of wind is the device which is used to measure the speed of the wind is anemometer. Option D is correct. Next question, the number of oscillation per second is known as frequency. Frequency is known as the number of oscillation per second. Option B is correct answer. Next, which of the following does not represent the electric power in circuit? Electric power in the I square R, right? I R square and V square by R. So here this one is I R square is wrong. So V equal to I square R. So here option B is correct answer. He is asking about does not represent the electric power. So option B is correct answer. Next one, when the diameter of the wire is doubled. So if the wire diameter has been doubled, it would be 1/4. Resistance will become 1/4 because the thickness of the wire is usually represented by its diameter. So option D is correct answer. The lightest gas which is filled in the balloons. So in the periodic table, if you observe that first element is hydrogen, helium, next one is helium, lithium, next one, so it goes on. So here the lightest gas which filled in the balloon, so the lightest element is, first one is hydrogen, but in the balloons we don't use this hydrogen because it is flammable gas. So hydrogen is a flammable gas, so which won't be used in the gas balloon. So after that, helium is inflammable, so helium is the lightest gas which is filled in balloon. So don't confuse between hydrogen and helium. We won't use hydrogen because it is a flammable. We will, next element is helium, so we are using helium. Next question, what is the CGS unit of force? CGS unit of force is dyne. Option D is correct. Next one, a train starts suddenly, the passenger bend towards is an example of, it is an example of inertia. So when a train is moving suddenly, the passenger will get bent backwards. This is a good example of inertia. Optical fiber works on the principle of, actually optical fiber will works on the principle of total internal reflection. Option B is correct. Next, the purity of milk is measured by, the purity of the milk is measured by lactometer. Lactometer is measured by, measures its density. Actually the milk density, by the seeing the milk density, the lactometer will tell the purity of milk. So here option C is correct answer. Okay friends, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please do like, share and comment. If you haven't watched my previous video, which consists 1 to 50 questions, please, the link is given in the description below. Please go and watch it. Thank you.